There's something with driving and music that is unparalleled to really any other activity. When it comes to making music, the car test is crucial. It's like pretty much the final stage of music making. You're sitting in a studio all day, it's stagnant. The car test, you got the visuals. The car test, you can turn it as loud as you want. You get to see the sights and hear the music. It's almost like a movie.
The journey at Chase Atlantic started from a long process of figuring out who we were and what we wanted to do in life as musicians and music, and got into producing very early myself and saw other artists doing their thing and got really inspired and thought, you know what, if I can do it myself, maybe we can have like a way into it without having to, you know, do the other artist things.
It's a good process. It's unformulaic. And we make a lot of music, and so me, myself, I'll start producing a beat, and then it'll go on to Christian, or Christian will start making a beat and he'll send it to me.
I think we all bring something different, for sure. I grew up in like a band world. Mitchell's just songwriting is just above like anyone I've ever met. And then Clinton, when it comes to his vocal production, his video editing, he's just, yeah, he's in another planet completely. It's weird, like, since high school, we've been together every day for 6-7 years. So the individual story is kind of all like one. Chase Atlantic is like a unity of brothers.
Clint and I grew up in a very small city and just like a medium to low income, like family environment. Big dreams. There's not a lot of people that come out of Cairns. I think we're kind of the first to make a name for where we grew up. But it's a beautiful environment, and I think that kind of gave us the freedom to explore different things. We didn't know any of this stuff, you know what I mean? There was no one around us doing stuff like this. I think we wanted to kind of break those barriers and put a little more flair into where we come from. A little more edge. I don't feel euphoria, no, I feel empty. New house, new car, I feel empty. The whole essence of Empty, like the song starts out with just like one simple instrument, but also with the lyrics being like very testimonial and kind of honest as well.
I think that song kind of just resonated with feeling so alone stepping away from Australia and, you know, into this big world of music in America, and you know, there's times you just sit there where you just feel so empty.
So in my verse I say like old friends turning into strangers, and that was just kind of talking about the life that we were living and then coming back home and it being so different. Old friends turning into strangers, new friends that becoming dangerous, her friends never really like me, they'll do anything they can to spite me. My friends count on my lip. To other people it seemed like we were doing this amazing things, new country, you know, we made it to America, but we still kind of felt the same from the start, if not like worse, because we've kind of done everything we've always wanted and we still felt the same.
It's a fake chorus.
Tell me what's the reason I feel empty.
How are we feeling? Are you still feeling empty?
Well, the plan was 1 year in LA, ended up getting stuck for 2 years.
I mean, this song kind of fits too for like being isolated and all that.
That's like my everyday life. But yeah, like, it's not debilitating, it's just like, this empty void.
Yeah.
I don't know, as an artist, it's weird, like you feel like you have like this void inside of you. There's like there's something missing in your stomach and you don't know how to fill it. I think the closest the closest I've ever been to feeling it is creating music.
It's been a great journey, a lot of ups and downs. The ups are worth it though. I think it's been a great learning platform for the way my brain works, and I couldn't have shared that with better people. So yeah, personally I love it and love the brothers.
I think that's the other thing about LA as well. You come here and you expect dreams come true, but you know what I mean? Like if you're not around the right people, it can be pretty
daunting.
Yeah, pretty scary and like kind of terrible.
You gotta really wanna make it on your own if you come out here. Like everyone's, it's fight for all out here. There's some good people in here. You find your good people and you got a good circle. But we always had each other, luckily. But I think that we didn't come here hoping to make it. We just came here because it was convenient, because we knew we were gonna try our best to like do it ourselves.
Yeah.
We didn't want to rely on anyone else at all.
All right, let's test it.
Have a test.
I'm not trying to reach a certain destination and be like, all right, cool, that's the finish line. I'm trying to make this last as long as possible because it truly is an outlet, like making music. It's about being true to our own story. And I think that's what makes an artist an artist.
Back
very good driving, Mitchell, actually.
Today?
For some of your best, yeah.